The operations report? Oh, we see that the CL Nagara has been hit. This means that... but we don't know if it's really been hit. The real meat is the reinforcements arriving at the bottom of the page. Also, the fortifications that have been built. We'll start from the top again. Over here, we've increased again, I think. I think it was 3. Even though we've been bombarded by the enemy. Yeah, and our experience has all increased. So we'll rebuild it and redivide it. Redistribute the pain. Down here, oh, there's the combat. We almost got exterminated. Every single squad is disabled. So we will be moving. Oh, where shall we go? Cheng Chao? Okay, we go here. No. I don't think such a good idea. We'll have to cross a river and into enemy territory. No, maybe not. Let's go to Nanyang. We'll set everyone to march and divide the unit to try to recover something. There we are. We have Nanyang has a garrison requirement of 20. That's about all we have left. No, we have 46, but that's pretty pathetic. We've collected over nearly 1,000 at Nanyang. We'll try to move around the top of this hill and down on Kaifeng. We've captured Bao Tao. Now we go back into combat, into rest and divide. We're going to try a bombardment attack. We'll use the largest unit here just to see how the enemy, what's still on the enemy side. Plus, maybe we can keep him, keep his disruption up high. He's moved across the river. Looks like he might be chasing us again. We're moving so slowly. The enemy has moved into Chusien, so we better hurry up and get everything down, rebuild it in, and put it in combat mode. We have approximately 1,000 points here. We'll take a look and see with hotkey W to see which way he marched. He marched straight in from the east. And he bombed this unit, so dropped it into combat. He moved a little bit more slowly. I'm going to gamble. Okay, my headquarters unit. I'm going to actually order it to combat and stop here and rest. If the enemy unit moves in behind the other one, I'm going to move my unit up behind it and try to cut off its line of supply. Same as I'm trying to do over here. If I lose and get killed, so what? It's just a few support squads and a headquarters. It's not like they're combat troopers. We've moved in nearly to, I think, Chang. Yeah. Changsha is probably the most. I Chang is probably the most powerful hex in the Chinese side right now, with 2,900 assault value. We're going to rebuild and try to regain, build a little bit more strength before deciding which objective we want to take on. Lots of time. lots of time. We're already at level 3 fortifications. Well, we can build maybe a little bit more. Well, that's fine. We'll just burn it up. Don't know if we're going to go down through here. This, he's coming up. Is he heading for Nanyang or Zhengzhou? I'm going to gamble even more. I'm going to move my headquarters unit right now towards the enemy. If he doesn't move out of the way before I get there, I'll make sure I just cancel the order and reissue it. He bombed Rangoon last night. Oh, I don't have very many fires, but I'm okay. I'll try. I'll divide it and I'll set the smallest one. Yeah, on flying night operations. There's just not very many fighters left. Here's my screw up. This turns all about my screw ups. Looking at this base, it's a zero. No wonder I can't unload anything here. It's a zero. So I'm going to set it for to try to unload here at Cox Bazaar. This base force is moving forward, and we'll start building here. He's already got a port of one, so to order it to stockpile. We'll move this AKL over to Chittagong. And we're sending another one out, resupply. Blockade runner. Here's another blockade runner. We'll order it for Cox's Bazaar. Another ship is heading for Rangoon. Oh, hey, wonderful. We managed to pick up the entire force at Diego Garcia. Heading for Cochin. Checking over in South Africa. We have another ship, so we'll form up a transport group. A reinforcement. We've also received some ground reinforcements already. So we'll move it into a strategic move, ready to load. And we'll set the future for what? Lido. Okay. No. Oh, it didn't work. I guess I missed the center of the hex or something. Good lord. Try it again. Your hat. All right. We'll set all for that. Oh, what the heck? Set all, right? That should set all the other. We'll load troops. We'll load the heavy anti-aircraft unit. Oh, why does it still say Jorhat? I use set all. The other anti-aircraft unit should be set. Oh man. If anyone wants to, one of the big reasons why these videos are so long is we just so tedious doing this one at a time. Okay, we'll set the next one for Jorhat. One for Lido. Now we missed the middle of this hex again. Lido, and I think this is Dimapur. Yeah, the Dimapur. Okay, we're going to load the heavy artillery, heavy anti-aircraft artillery. Verify it. Plenty of room. Right. Now we'll set the destination. We're just trying to get it up to a rail line. Cochin is good. We'll turn off the fueling. Nothing happening in Aden. Oh, here's two ships. They just seem to be stopped right here. What happened? They just pop out and just not move? They don't have a course plot. Okay. We'll undock and send them back to Abaddon now. Abaddon has most of the tankers are loaded, so we're going to create another one. They're not going to sit around and wait for the cargo ships. We're just going to sail alone for Karachi. Now that they're sailing, we'll try to transfer in some replacement ships, but we can't seem to fit them. None of these seem to fit in the dock. I must have redocked the tankers. Okay, undock the tankers. Transfer. Okay, now we can add extra ships. Only two. Nothing else. Okay. If it seems like we have too many ships at Abaddon, I'll send the rest of them next time over to Cape Town or somewhere else. There seems to be a huge backlog of available tankers and not enough supplies to go around. These two are going to head for, instead of for Abaddon, here come my inbound little freighters. And a relief, my more little freighters under escort. We'll head straight for Calcutta instead of to Madras first. Check the ships. Oh, Malaya, the scene of my folly. First turn, the enemy walked in and hammered 25% of my assault points. Next turn, it's like he walked into a total brick wall. What the hell's going on here? There's two units here now. And he's marching down the far side. I've counted up all the assault value on my side. I have about 500 to 600 assault value, but it's spread throughout the peninsula. He's got 7 units here, 2 units here. My units are very, very small. So I think I have to admit I've screwed up. I've thrown in 120,000 I've added about 60,000-70,000 supplies and maybe 100,000 in fuel. I think I'm going to pull them out because I think I have made an error to put so much in. I overestimated my ability to stop the enemy. I thought just throwing in supplies would help my troops. It doesn't. My troops are crap. And they're going to be ground into hamburger. All I'm doing is giving the enemy more supplies and fuel. So I think I'm going to... My convoys are already here, so I think I'm going to load up. I'm going to pull out whatever I can and head for Darwin. I can admit I made a mistake. I've wasted days here, but not that many. It's only 10 days into the game, but I've probably wasted 2 or 3 bringing in supplies here. So... I've sorted them out. Oops, where are they? I'm just amazing. Every single ship I have here can actually dock. Just the size of this place. So we're loading up all the fuel and all the supplies that we brought in previously, as many as we can. There's also a couple of submarines here. One's damaged, but notice even with all this damage, she'll come out of the shipyard in about 2 days. We'll also, we're waiting, we'll fix the Evertsen, and here's another submarine. Even with her damage, she'll be done in 4 days. Here's the Prince of Wales still trying to get out of dry dock. We'll check the submarines that were up here. This is what you want to see. A totally empty submarine. All the torpedoes expended. Wow. Okay, so we'll order him back to Singapore for more torpedoes. All the other subs seem okay there. My S-37 goes out. Oh, wow, look at that. One torpedo left. I think it's safe to come home. They were still going to patrol, even with one torpedo. Can you imagine that? I can't believe it. Okay, we'll return to rearm. We'll check the other subs. Another one! Look at that! This guy's so aggressive, he's going after them with the guns. Back to Singapore you go. Moving down. Oh, look at, I've never seen Batavia and Sohor Baha so empty. Look at that! Sucked every ounce of supply out of them almost. And there's still 60,000 left of fuel, but that's not much. So we're sending them, we reorganized them, pulling every ship out of here. The empty ones, or the ones that are full, we're sending all the way straight to Darwin. Those vessels with still some space or empty are heading down to Sohor Baha to try to pull out the fuel. I'm going to try to load fuel alongside these supplies. I think it's possible to load two, both of them. The ships at Sohor Baha are going to continue to try pulling out more fuel and waiting for the ones arriving from Batavia so that we can join their escort. The Sea Lion continues to probe at the amphibious landing near Legazpi. We've rearmed, S-36 is now going to patrol the invasion beaches. She hasn't had much luck this far back. Sea Dragons in dock. We already have in the shipyard. Okay, three more days to repair. So we'll form up with S-39 came back to rearm. I'm mixing up the Sea Dragon and the S-39. Okay, form up. We'll select S-39, maximum reaction, and create a patrol zone for her, which consists of on the invasion beaches. We'll just have her sail right back and forth across all three. This is the turn of my folly. Look at that. I had all these ships, they were planned, and look, they haven't moved because she's still loading supplies, a few piddly little supplies, and she's managed to stop the whole process. Oh well, at least it gave a chance for the cruiser Australia to catch up. We'll transfer her in. Never blame the game for my own stupidity. Here's the transports just sitting here. Loaded up, we don't need them. They're in Townsville. Our resupply convoy has arrived. The Royal Navy Base Force is still loading. So we'll transfer the supply ships, unloaded supply ships, into the base. We're still loading. It's not big enough to hold them all. We'll transfer a few more into the base. We're trying to unload the tankers. And still, we cannot dock. So we will move this tanker into the base. Still unable to. The dock is just too small. Okay, we'll move it in, direct it into the base. And another large tanker. The last two tankers will unload. All these other ones will refuel. while we're waiting. Tulagi, ships have arrived, and we'll start unloading now. Over Oahu. Here's the line. Okay, so this is the same latitude, and there's the ships heading down this way, so we're about one day ahead of them. So I think it's right now we should be forming up, and we're going to put all the transports. We're taking the base forces and the combat engineer regiments, because we really need to build up that base. We're at 124% troop capacity and 169% excess cargo, so we should be able to get everything on here. Not wave bye-bye to our bulldozers. Now, the Kido Butai disappeared heading in this direction, so I think he might have moved and be based out of Truk, which could mean a lot of trouble for us. I'm sending a submarine out. I haven't seen much happening in the Marshall Islands since the beginning of the war. The replenishment convoy has arrived at Midway. I'm going to drop the oiler and the tenders into the base, as well as the minesweepers. We'll try to dock these and unload. Can we bring anything back out? No, there's no room for the tenders to unload. This would be a good place for a submarine tender. That's why we've dropped the oiler in here as well. We start to unload. We're building, but so slowly, because we only have 4 engineer squads and 2 bulldozers. It's going to take forever. The destroyers have joined up with the first group, so we're going to transfer a couple of them so that each group has a little bit better anti-submarine defense. Each one has 33 ships now. Okay, we'll try to bring these ships out. Oh, it's going to take forever. Only 5,000. It's going to take another 2 or 3 turns to load that. Got to send the destroyers back down to pick up the carrier now. Oh, these little units over on Annette Island, they're just a couple of points, 12 points each. So for the sake of neatness, we're going to buy them out. This base force is also only, 6 points? Yeah, I think we can afford that. Buy them out and move them to the mainland. We'll use them. Unfortunately, I didn't put them in strategic mode. They're in combat mode. So it takes too long. It takes 2 days to put into strategic mode before I can load. Why don't we just go after them with an amphibious group? We're so close, we can make a couple of runs. Yeah, it's only a size 1 base, so we might have to go in with amphibious. Okay, we'll form the amphibious task force. Why don't we go in with load troops? Not in combat, no. We're going to go pick up a unit, and we will order it according to location. It's Annette Island, down the bottom, I guess, somewhere. Annette Island, so there's 2, so how do we click? Do we right-click on this one or that one? No, not this one. This one, I on the right? I can't click on that. Okay, it only shows information. So, how do I select? Okay, click on this side. Bang. Okay, we're going to go retrieve that unit. Looks like, yeah, it's plotted to retrieve. Pick up the unit. This seems to be going the long way around. I don't know why it would do that. We'll use a waypoint. We're going to shallow water, and it's shorter this way. We're sending the now we have some extra bombers, so we're going to try to buy out these Mitchells before they leave on February. We've got some Bolos sitting in there, so we're going to swap out with the useless Bolos to get a couple of useful Mitchells, I hope. We'll leave the original path, it doesn't matter, and keep it at 0. We'll check. We see that there's also, oh, okay, there's a bomber force arrived in Bandoeng. There it is. It's a level bomber. So we'll set it for naval attack, as we won't have much other else to bomb. Set it on training. No. Well, we may as well take reinforcements if we can. We'll fly her up to Batavia. And the different base forces have sorted themselves out. They're all four components are at Batavia. I'm going to drop it into combat mode. And this one's already in combat mode. That's why we couldn't join. Okay, all three together. In the south, in the south is the southern base four. We can't join it together yet. It's the last one. There we go. I have to take it out of strategic in order to... But at least they're all in the same place. We'll do our usual check on the aircraft. Sort them. Did we miss any reinforcements? Nope. Seems to be all right. Oh, almost forgot. These are the refugee ships. We were heading over to Soropaja to pick up a load, but it looks like there's nothing to pick up anymore. So, we still want to grab something. Let's take a look at this. No, there's nothing here. We're going to stop off, and there's a few supplies at Ambon. There's more at Kendari. So we're going to order the ships to stop off here. And take all their supplies. If we're of the same mentality, like Singapore, if these are doomed men anyway, they aren't going to matter. So we'll take about 3,700 here. I'll send this one over Kendari. We could pick up a load of fuel, so I'll send these over. They're far enough ahead, we'll send them over to pick up fuel at Soropaja. The Dutch start the fight but miss. Second time round, lucky. Sauri fires, no result. Pike fires, misses. The Dutch tries to penetrate the heavy cruiser screen, gets caught, and it takes heavy damage. Rabaul is bombed. Clark Field bombed. Rangoon under air attack. The Buffaloes get a few. Wen Chow bombed. Kukong bombed. Kuei Lin bombed. The ground forces at Johor Bahru bombed. Pike gets another victim. Bombardment attack at Kuei Sui. Bombardment attack at Nanning. It appears as though the enemy guns may be larger than ours because we took casualties and they did not. Bombardment attack at Cheng Chau. Same situation here. It seems as though the enemy guns may be larger than ours. But we can also take a look and see what forces are on the other side. Just the 35th Division.